Vanakkam my dear students, in before video we completed miscellaneous practice problems. Then we have challenging problems. In challenging problems 11th one already I taught in the video number 16. Okay, now we are going to see 12th one. Give an example and verify each of the following statements. Okay, so they given some statements, you are going to give an example and we are going to prove that. Okay, so the collection of all non-zero rational numbers is closed under division. So they clearly given here non-zero rational numbers. Why they take non-zero rational numbers? If you take zero, then collection of rational numbers is not closed under division. So here they given non-zero, so we should not take that zero. So zero only the one rational number, so which are going doesn't satisfy the condition, you know. So non-zero rational numbers we are going to take here. So let us take A equal to 5 by 4, B equal to minus 1 by 2, B, two non-zero rational numbers. So A divided by B. So A divided by B equal to 5 by 4 divided by minus 1 by 2. Already I told divide you have to change into multiply and write reciprocal of this next number. So 5 by 4 into minus 1 by 2, what is the reciprocal? Minus 2 by 1. Here you can cancel, you know, 2 1s are, 2 2s are. So what will you get? 5 into minus 1, minus 5, denominator 2 into 1, 2. So is in Q. Q means rational numbers. So therefore collection of non-zero rational numbers is closed under division. If they ask collection of rational numbers is closed now, definitely not. But collection of non-zero rational numbers is closed under division. Okay, next, second one. Subtraction is not commutative for rational numbers. We are going to prove subtraction is not commutative. So let us take here A value 1 by 2, B value minus 5 by 6, B, two rational numbers. I take here these two rational numbers. You may take on your own and do then sum. Okay, A minus B equal to 1 by 2 minus minus 5 by 6. So minus into minus you will get plus. Plus 5 by 6. Here you have to take LCM. What is the LCM? 6 will be the LCM, no. So you have to multiply and divide by here 3. So 1 3 is 3 plus here you have 5. 6 is the LCM. 3 plus 5 will get 8. 8 by 6. If you cancel in 2 table, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8. You will get 4 by 3. Next step we are going to find B minus A. B minus 5 by 6 minus 1 by 2. Here also you have to take LCM. Here 3 by 3. So I will get minus 5. Minus 3 divided by 6. Minus 3, minus 5 minus 3 will get minus 8. If you cancel in 2 table, 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, you will get minus 4 by 3. Observe here, A minus B you got 4 by 3. B minus A you got minus 4 by 3. Is this both are same? Definitely not, you know, you have negative sign here. So A minus B is not equal to B minus A. Therefore, subtraction is not commutative for the rational numbers. Third one, division is not associative for rational numbers. We are going to prove division is not associative for rational numbers. Let A equal to 2 by 5, B equal to 6 by 5, C equal to 3 by 5, B, 3 rational numbers. So now here I take A, B, C, these rational numbers. Okay. So now I am going to check the associative property. A divided by B divide C equal to, so what is the A value? 2 by 5 divided by B value 6 by 5 divided by C value is 3 by 5. So first you have to solve inner brackets, isn't it? So this divide you are going to change into multiply and write reciprocal of 3 by 5. So 2 by 5 divided by 6 by 5 into what is the reciprocal of 3 by 5? 5 by 3. 5, 5 will get cancelled. 3 1s are, 3 2s are. That is 2 divided by 1. Here also again you have got divide. Change it into multiply and write reciprocal of this. 2 by 5 into 2 by 1. 2 by 1, what is the reciprocal? 1 by 2. So here 2, 2 will get cancelled. So 1 by 5 got, take it as equation number 1. Next, A divide B divide C. So substitute that A, B, C values. Here divide bracket you have to solve first. here you have divide, change it into multiply and write reciprocal of this. Reciprocal of 6 by 5 is 5 by 6. Here also 5 and 5 will get cancelled. 2 1s are 3 3s are. Here you simplify, you will get 1 by 3 divide by 3 by 5. Here also divide, change into multiply, write reciprocal. 1 by 3 into 5 by 3. So 1 into 5, 5, 3 3s are 9. Take it as equation number 2. So from 1 and 2, observe 1 and 2, 1 by 5 is not equal to 5 by 9. A divide B divide C is not equal to A divide B divide C. Therefore, division is not associative for rational numbers. Fourth one, distributive property of multiplication over subtraction is true for rational numbers. That is, A into B minus C equal to AB minus AC. So, I take here, let A equal to 2 by 9, B equal to 3 by 6, C equal to 1 by 3, B, 3 rational numbers. So, we are going to prove A into B minus C equal to AB minus AC. So, first I take LHS part, A into B minus C equal to, substitute the values, A 2 by 9 into B 3 by 6 minus 1 by 3. So, here you are going to solve, you have to, LCM is 6, for 3 and 6, what is the LCM? 6. Here you have to do multiply and divide with 2. So, 3 minus 2 divide by 6, 3 minus 2 is 1, 1 by 6. Here you can cancel 2, 1s are 2, 3s are, so 1 into 1, 1, 9 3s are 27. So, you got 1 by 27. Take it as equation number 1. Next, move on to RHS. AB minus AC equal to A value and then B value minus A into C value. You have to substitute. Here, you can simplify. Multiply, you can directly simplify. 3 1s are 3 3s are. 2 1s are 2 3s are. So, what you got? 1 divided by 9. Here, there is no possibility of a cancellation. 2 1s are 2, 9 3s are 27. So, for 9 and 27, what is the LCM? 27. So, here you have to multiply and divide by 3. So, 1 3s are 3, 9 3s are 27. So, 27 is the LCM, 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2, you will get 1. 1 divided by 27. Take it as equation number 2. So, from 1 and 2, A into B minus C equal to AB minus AC. Therefore, distributive property of multiplication over subtraction is true for rational numbers. Did you understand the sum? Fifth one, the mean of two rational numbers is rational and lies between them. So, we are going to find first mean of two rational numbers and we are going to prove that number is in rational number and also that lies between the given rational numbers. So, let us take A equal to 2 by 11 and B 5 by 6 be two rational numbers. So, mean of A and B, what is the formula already I taught from the starting itself? What is the mean of, at its average formula we studied, you know, that is nothing but mean. Mean of A and B equal to 1 by 2 into A plus B. It is the formula. Now, we are going to find mean of 2 by 11 and 5 by 6 equal to 1 by 2 into 2 by 11 plus 5 by 6. Here you have to take LCM. So, what is the LCM? 66 will be the LCM. Here you have to multiply and divide with 6. Here 11 divided by 11. Okay. So, here you will get 12 plus 55 divided by 66. 12 plus 55 you will get 67 divided by 66. So, 1 into 67, 67. 2 into 66, you will get 132. 67 by 132 is in rational numbers. So, is in rational numbers. The mean of two rational numbers is rational. Also, 2 by 11 equal to, so here the denominator is 132. So, when will you get 132 as the denominator? Na? If you multiply by 11 by 12, na, you will get 132. So, multiply both numerator and denominator by 12, you will get 24 by 132 here. Here you have 5 by 6. So, 132 you have to got. What you have to multiply with 6? 22. So, both numerator and denominator multiply with 22, you will get 110 by 130. Therefore, 67 by 132 lies between 24 by 132 and 110 by 132. So, 24 by 132 is less than 67 by 132 is less than 110 by 132. So, we can conclude here the mean lies between the given rational numbers, that is 2 by 11 and 5 by 6. Now, we proved the mean of two rational numbers is rational and also it lies between them. Okay. 13th one, if 1 by 4 of ragi adai weight 120 grams, what will be the weight of 2 by 3 of the same ragi adai? They given 1 by 4 part of the ragi adai weights 120 grams. We are going to find 2 by 3 weight of the same ragi adai. So first we are going to find what is the weight of one ragi adai, then it will be easy to find 2 by 3 of the weight. Okay. So let the weight of the one ragi adai is be x grams. We are going to assume that. So 1 by 4 of x. 1 by 4 of ragi adai they given as 120 gram. 1 by 4 of x equal to 120 gram. Of means multiply 1 by 4 into x equal to 120. So 1 by 4 goes that side and it will take reciprocal into 4 by 1. If you multiply you will get 480 gram. So x value is 480 gram. That is the weight of one ragi adai is 480 gram. So they asked to find 2 by 3 of that. So 2 by 3 of ragi adai equal to 2 by 3 into 480 gram. 2 into 160 will get 320 gram. The weight of 2 by 3 of same ragi adai equal to 320 gram. Okay, did you understand the sum? 14th one, if P plus 2Q equal to 18 and PQ equal to 40, find 2 by P plus 1 by Q. So write the given first, P plus 2Q equal to 18 and PQ equal to 40. Now we are going to find this value, 2 by P plus 1 by Q. So here you have to take LCM, but the denominators are variables. So this you have to multiply these two, that should be the LCM. PQ will be the LCM. So PQ na, then what you have to multiply here? Q by Q. Here what you have to multiply and divide? P by P. So then what will you get? 2Q plus 1 into P, P divide by PQ. Okay, next. So 2Q plus P, they are given P plus 2Q. So addition satisfies commutative law, isn't it? So P plus 2Q is equal to 2Q plus P. Both the values are same only. So you can substitute 18 divided by PQ value is 40. So you can cancel this in two table. 2 9s are 18, 2 20s are 40. You will get the answer as 9 by 20. Therefore, 2 by P plus 1 by Q equal to 9 by 20. Is it clear? So move on to 15th one. Find x if 5x by 5 into 3 3 by 4 equal to 21. So write the given 5x by 5 into 3 3 by 4 equal to 21. Here they given the mixed fraction. First you have to convert into improper fraction. Here you have to multiply. Here you have to add. Isn't it? 5 5s are 25 plus 6. So you are going to add this 6. So 25 plus 6 divided by what is the denominator here? 5. Next, here you have to multiply, here add. 4 3s are 12. 12 plus 3, 15 divided by, here the denominator is 4. Now we can cancel this. 5 1s are 5, 3s are 15. So what will you get? 25 plus 6 by 1 is nothing but 25 plus 6. Into here you have 3 by 4 equal to 21. Send this 3 by 4 to the RHS part. You will get the reciprocal, that will become 4 by 3. Here you can cancel 3. 3 1s are 3. 7s are 21. 7 4s are, you will get 28. So 25 plus 6 equal to 28. X equal to, send this 25 to right hand side, it will become minus 25. 28 minus 25, you will get 3. X value is 3. Did you understand these sums? 16th one, by how much does 1 by 10 by 11 exceed 1 by 10 divided by 11? Okay. So that we are going to find the difference between these two. So you have to measure what is that larger number and what is the smaller number. So x means this must be larger and this must be smaller. How much means you are going to find the difference. So the difference equal to 1 divided by 10 by 11 minus 1 by 10 divided by 11. First we are going to simplify this. 1 means nothing but 1 by 1. So divide by 10 by 11, you know, it will goes to the numerator, na, multiply 11, it will take reciprocal, 11 by 10 minus, here you have 1 by 10, here you have 11 by 1. It will goes to the numerator, it will take reciprocal into 1 by 11. So what will you get here? 1 into 11, 11, 1 tens are 10. 1 into 1, 1, 10 elevens are 110. Then what is the LCM now? 110 is the LCM. Here you have to multiply and divide with 11. So 11 elevens are 121 minus 1 divided by 110. So 121 minus 1, 120 divided by 110, 0, 0 will get cancelled, 12 by 11. Therefore, 1 divided by 10 by 11 exceeds 1 by 10 divided by 11 by 12 by 11. Is it clear, my children? That's all in this video. I think you are all understood. Thank you.